Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2023. Calculate work days, even for non-standard work weeks. Well, I'll be podcasting this entire book. Click the I on the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. So I talked about this feature back in episode 1977 for fill weekdays. You right-click the fill handle and drag, and when you let go, you choose fill weekdays, and you see that it fills Monday through Friday. Works great for a lot of countries in the world, but there's countries in the world where the weekdays, the weekend is not Saturday, Sunday, right? And just sorry, Microsoft Excel doesn't care about you. All right, so we're going to talk about how to calculate the number of work days between two dates. And if we just need to know the number of days between two dates, we take the later date minus the earlier date plus one, and you'll see how many work days there are, right? That works great if you work every day, right? But if you want to leave out the weekends, the Saturdays and Sundays, equal net work days has been around, well, in the analysis tool back, you know, a long time, it became an official part of Excel in Excel 2007. So you specify the start date, comma, the end date, close paren, and that throws out the Saturdays and Sundays, all right? It's still a problem, though, because it's counting holidays. So if we want to leave out the holidays, then we use equal net work days from the start date to the end date, comma, and then an optional argument, where are the holidays? So I'll choose that. I'll press F4 to lock that down, and it'll calculate the number of work days less holidays. All right, so now let's calculate this for all of these. We'll copy this down and say fill without formatting, and you'll see that here there are 351 days, 251 days if you throw out Saturdays and Sundays, but 239 days if you threw out all of these holidays, right? Great, great function if you're in the United States. Or actually, if you're not in any of the countries listed in rows 2 through 6, all of these countries, your weekend is Friday and Saturday. Nepal, Saturday. Afghanistan, Thursday and Friday. Here in Iran, only Friday. And then the completely evil one that nothing will ever, well, not nothing, but it will be difficult to deal with is Brunei. I had to go figure out where Brunei is. Is it true? Your weekend is Friday and Sunday? How miserable is Saturday? What? I don't know. It's a one-day work week? I guess, I don't know. I don't know. Anyway. All right. So what if you have to calculate a weekend that's not Saturday and Sunday? Here's a manufacturing plant that's working Monday through Saturday, so their only work day off is Sunday. Well, I think it was Excel 2010, they gave us equal NETWORKDAYS.INTL. INTL, and it starts out the same. Here's the start date. Here's the end date. And then the new third argument, we get to specify what the weekend is. And in this case, it would be Sunday only. It still isn't going to handle Brunei where it's Friday and Sunday, but for any other two consecutive days or one consecutive day, there's an option for that now. And then the holidays out here, press F4, and you have your answer. I'll do Alt-ESF for paste special formulas, enter, and we can copy that one down. All right, now, how about Brunei or just anything that is a non-standard work week? Back in the day, barbershops used to be closed on Sundays and Wednesdays. I used to live up in Ohio, and we'd go shopping at the Hartville Marketplace and Flea Market. This place, wonderful place, by the way, if you're there, to see the Pro Football Hall of Fame, just 20 minutes up the road. They're open Monday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, right? So their weekend then is Tuesday, Wednesday, Sunday. How are we ever going to do that with network days? Well, this is so cool. They've added this crazy new option that's not documented in the tooltip. So NETWORKDAYS.INTL. Here's the start date, comma, here's the end date, comma, and then the secret one that's not here in the drop-down at all is, in quotes, seven binary digits, zeros or ones, starting with a Monday. One means it's a weekend, zero means it's open. So the Hartville Marketplace, they're open on Monday, so put a zero. They're closed on Tuesday and Wednesday. They're open on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. They're closed on Sunday. Close the quotes. Holidays, oh no, there are no holidays at this place because, frankly, if the 4th of July falls on a Monday or a Thursday, that's their biggest day. Everyone is off from work, and so they all go flying into the place. It'll be tough to get a parking spot. All right, so the actual number of work days between those two dates. I'll right click and fill without formatting. Alright, I love this one. Kind of secret. If you go into Excel Help, you'll find it. But if you're just looking in the tooltip, you will never know it's there. Unless, of course, you own this book and on page 99, you read about it, or if you saw this video. So either way, cool. Click the eye in the top right hand corner to buy the book. $10 is an ebook, $25 for the print book. All of these amazing tips. 2.5 months worth of podcasts all in the palm of your hand. All right, date math in Excel. Subtract the earlier date from the later date plus one. That counts Saturdays and Sundays. To ignore weekends, use the net work days function. To not count holidays, you would use the third argument at net work days. Make sure to press F4 for that. For non-standard work weeks, NETWORKDAYS.INTL. That allows for any two or one consecutive weekend. And then there's a secret seven binary digit code for work weeks that are not consecutive days, even in the country of Brunei. You'd be able to handle that Friday, Sunday work week. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.